Hello all, welcome to IQ Pop. In this lecture, I will discuss on components of computer system and mainly on CPU. So, in our previous lecture, we have seen the organization of a computer. So, in center, there is a CPU and all other peripherals like program memory, temporary memory, which is RAM, output and input components are connected with CPU. So, we'll take a deep look at this organization. So CPU, you can see here, it may be i7 or any Intel or any other processor. Temporary memory is RAM. Program memory is a hard disk. Usually we use it as hard disks, or it may be some nowadays SSD or some other ROM. So standard input device, which is keyboard, and standard output device, which is monitor. So there is lots of other input and output devices. We will come to that later. Now, before going into discussion of CPU, let's see how these components are going to communicate with each other. So on motherboard, there is a input output controller, and everything is connected to that controller. So this is a controller, that means it can control their communication and what they can access. Now you can see that CPU and RAM are connected with that controller. On the other side, secondary memory, IO devices, input output devices and network devices are all connected to that controller. Now here is a image of motherboard. On this, as we know that all the components are going to be placed on the motherboard, and through motherboard it is going to be communicated. So here you can see this is a slot for CPU. Whatever CPU are going to be there in the system, that is going to be inserted in this slot. These are the RAM slot. We all have heard about RAM, right? So RAMs are going to be inserted here. These are PCI slot, and these are the at the back side of your computer or CPU of desktop, you will find few ports. So these are these ports. So what does it look like from the back side is like this. So there are parallel ports, RJ45 port or network port. There is a USB port, VGA port through which we connect our monitor. There may be some serial port, some PS2 port and mouse, another PS2 port. Usually we use them for connecting mouse and keyboard. Now, CPU. So, CPU are having mainly three part, or you can say three component inside it, which are namely ALU, control unit and register. So here I have shown you two CPU. One is Qualcomm Snapdragon, which is very popular in mobile, and another is Core i7 Intel processor, which is very popular in new computers and desktops and laptops. Okay, so what is CPU? CPU is the heart or brain of a computer, and electronic circuit. It fetches the input instruction from the commands from the memory unit and performs arithmetic and logical operations and stores the processed data back to memory, or it may be displayed on the monitor. Now, what is ALU? ALU is arithmetic logical unit. It does mainly two things, arithmetic operations and logical operations. Arithmetic operations are like addition, subtraction, depending on the person, multiplication and division also. And logical operations are AND, OR, NOT, JOR, BITC operator, all are kind of logical operations. Now control units. So control unit mainly controls the other elements of the CPU. Mainly the controlling the transfer of data and instruction among the other units of a computer. It manages and coordinates the unit of all the units of a computer, obtains the instruction from the memory, interprets them and directs the operation of the computer, communicates with IO devices for transfer of data and result from the storage, and does not process any data. Okay, it only controls. Register are very high speed memory and very small also, as they are going to be residing into the CPU chip itself. So they can be thought of a hardware version of a variable in a software. Okay, so who writes a code, they will understand what a variable in software. Okay, now why do we use it? Basically, our CPU are very much, you can say, capable or having very high speed. So when you are having a CPU of high speed, you must have, you know, supply of data which will cater that speed or processing speed, okay, so that your CPU will not stand idle. Okay, so for that reason we need registers inside CPU which will provide or cater that speed. Okay, so but one thing is that it is very costly, but it is having very high speed. Next thing is Moore's law. That according to that law, the number of transistors in a dense integrated circuit doubles about every 2 years. So every 2 years, number of transistors are going to be doubled in dense integrated circuit, which are basically the processor. Now if you look at the evolution of processor from 2003 to current year, in 2003 there was single core processor, you can see 1.7 million transistor was embedded on a 130 nanometer chip. Now you see the change after 2 years. In 2005 the first dual core processor came with size only 90 nanometer. Okay, then in 2006 first quad core processor came, which was called as i3 processor. Okay, it was of size 65 nanometer. In 2010 first hexa core processor i5 processor came with size 32 nanometer. In 2013 6 core with 12 threads processor came, which was having 1.86 billion transistor in it in only 22 nanometer, which was i7 processor. Now in 2018 we have i9 processor with 10 cores and 20 threads in, and it is size of 14 nanometer. Now why do we need a better processor? The most important reason is that high performance of the processor. It should consume less energy, it should generate less heat, fast internet access and perfection in processing, better video quality. Thank you for watching. Like, comment, share and subscribe, and hang on with me to watch more lectures.